Hi, it's Jill. I'm back again. I don't know if any of my film was recording. I don't know if my battery was dead. My husband started calling me, so I had to shut it off. And when I went to shut it off, it was already off. So, I don't know if I've recorded anything at all. So, what I'm working on, just in case I haven't recorded anything, is the Sesame Street. And I already filmed first ones that I did, and I was showing you how I pieced them together, and that's about as far as I got. And I'm trying to reopen my software. I want anybody that has the Silhouette software, if you could please leave me a message or just a comment and let me know if you're having issues where all of a sudden when you're working on something, it's fine when you first open the software, but after the software is open for a while, all of a sudden it starts blinking and gets really slow. Then I have to shut it down and restart it. And the downside of that is that because of the amount of files I have, it takes forever to reload. And it's doing it all the time. So then I started switching out all my files. My mission is to get all my files on an external hard drive. And that's a slow process. I've got a lot going on. So it isn't something I have all the time in the world to sit there and figure it out. But anyway, I cut all of these in pieces. If I didn't, again, I apologize if I'm repeating myself, but I don't know when this cut off. I glittered all my pieces, and I'm just finishing up the last of them. And that doesn't look like it goes. That has to go there. Let me see, that one goes there. Okay, that one goes there. Let me see here. Oh yeah, right there. In order to make them 2 feet, I know I've done these in the past, and I'm gonna be so embarrassed if I've repeated myself again and again and that it was really filming, but I just wanted to give everybody an update. Because, again, a lot of folks have been contacting me asking me if everything is okay. And I haven't had a chance to get back to everybody who's asked to let them know, yes, everything is great. I just am extremely busy with the care of my mother because she's been in the hospital twice in 6 weeks. For 8 days the first time, and this last time it was only for a couple days, but she had a viral infection that time around, and there's no antibiotics aren't going to do any good. I think her immune and everything is a little bit weakened because of the pneumonia. And the thing that's really hard is I know she's getting sick from the grandkids, but she absolutely refuses to not see them every chance she can, and I don't blame her. You know, but like she said, it's no quality of life, and so she's almost 90, and she wants whatever time she has left, she wants to be memorable. So we keep hanging out around the kids, and she gets sick, but she's having fun, guys. And I just got the report back the other day on her. Yeah, I've got his arms on now, already glittered. And when I'm done, I'm going to put a little glitter at that seam just to make it look more finished off. I took her in for all of her tests last Friday, which was Friday evening. She ended up in the emergency or Friday morning. She went in on Thursday and had all this test done. Blood work, x-rays, cardiogram, all this stuff done. Ended up in the hospital. Had to take her by ambulance at 4 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, after she was at the doctor's office with a virus called Corona virus. And I feel like I've said this before, so that could have been on my last video. And I do apologize. Oh, guys, you know what? Anybody that wants to give me a dingy for a negative remark, I'm gonna let you today, because I'm gonna say I would give myself one too. But this video is mainly geared to my faithful friends that have been through all of my trials and tribulations by following me on YouTube and are just so incredibly kind. I have gotten the messages this last week or so, I don't know, that have just brought me to tears. I cannot believe how many good people there are out there. You know, sometimes when something bad happens, you think, oh, you know, what horrible people or whatever. But man, there's far more good people than there are bad people. And those of you that I haven't gotten back to, it isn't that I didn't get your message. It's I might be sitting up in the hospital reading it on my phone, or sitting in line somewhere reading it in my car, because you have no idea. No idea what I've been through. But people just, and right when I need it, because I'm starting to beat myself up and feeling really bad because I've not been up to date with things and not getting back to folks and overwhelmed with the care of my mother and, you know, reassuring myself that I did the right thing by having her move in, even though she's been in the hospital twice. You know, sometimes you wonder, you know, is it my fault? I should have left well enough alone and let her live where she was. But again, she was all alone, and that's not what she wanted. But I do feel bad because she, the first time when she was in the hospital, she was very disoriented because she was dehydrated, and she also, her oxygen saps were so low that she started hallucinating. And when she finally remembered where she was and things, she was just beside herself, uncontrollable bawling, just feeling horrible because she thinks she's a burden to me. And it, you guys, it's been an emotional roller coaster. I know I'm not talking about my crafting, guys, but again, my faithful followers know that I do that a lot. But anyway, continue prayers for my mom, and not just for her health and everything, but that we're trying to get her to stop feeling bad for a good situation. She feels bad, like she was crying again yesterday because she feels like she's a burden to us. And she's got dementia, so we're trying to write out signs and give her instructions on things to do, simple things, just like even breathing through her nose. This is one of the problems that she's having with her oxygen level, is she's not breathing deep enough. And so I had to make signs last night and put them up everywhere. Of course, I had to do it on my silhouette. But when she wakes up in the morning, to remind her, breathe through her nose. And you just have no idea what we have been, I mean my husband's been an absolute saint. He gets up every morning and makes her her breakfast and has breakfast with her. I'm usually getting ready, I stayed up until I think 1 in the morning last night because I had work to do. And but he gets up and he makes sure she eats fruit every day and for breakfast and whatever she needs. And God, he's such a good man. But anyway, I'm not telling you much about what I'm doing here, am I? And it's not like you haven't seen Sesame Street guys come along once or twice. I don't know how many films I have of them up, but here's another one, guys. It is what it is. And I'm just putting a little bit of this in here because, again, I want to cover up anywhere where I made little cut marks. She's all glittered anyway, so this isn't like it's going to pop out. One thing I will say about this large bottles of the stickles, they aren't a large bottle with a fine tip. They're a big bottle with a big tip, and they come out a lot different than they do in the small ones, in the small bottles. So, if any of you want to know where you get those, I get them at scrapbookpal.com. And they are nice to have, but they are not like using the little bottles. They're not even remotely. They're completely different. And I think this one is still a little bit wet. I want to go over how I did her. But since she doesn't appear to be totally dry yet, I'm going to make my signs up and then I'll be back for the third time. So, see you in a bit.
Hi.
Oh, excuse me. I'm back again. Just finishing up this last piece here. Just to show you how many pieces I had to cut Abby Kadabi in order to get a 2-foot piece. She is not one of the easier ones because you can't, what do I want to say? That I have the wrong side on this or the wrong head. As you can notice, I'm have. Oh, there we go. That's it. there's no way to cut her down without really making her substantially smaller. So she's got to be cut in a lot more pieces because she's holding these things. Okay, I think I got it right now. Okay, that one's for that side. So let me start with putting her together. Now this one, I'm not gonna lay the other way because I can tell from the back where it goes. I think I can. I tell you what. And let me see. Well, don't slip on me. I'm trying to cut out some signs now because there's personalized signs. The little girls' names are Cecilia and Sophia. And I'm making the street signs and saying Cecilia Street and Sophia Street. And I print them out on my 12 by 18, which I thought would be just perfect. And I print out 6 of them, and none of them are cutting out right. I'm not talking 6 signs. I've cut out 6 pages of the sign. And I keep trying and trying, so I decided I better change it to the 11 by 17 and see if that does better. I've just been having major issues with the software that I never had with the silhouette, and it's ever since I upgraded to the, when I got my new machine, which I don't even use, because the software, it's been a nightmare for me, and I don't really know why, and I do not have the time to sit on the phone with silhouette troubleshooting. I've just got way too much going on in my life that's just not an option right now. So I have to shut down every time the software decides to go bonkers on me. I just shut it down, restart the software, and then it works fine. The problem that I have with doing that when I'm busy is that it takes at least 15 minutes to start back up. It's really, really a pain. I'm going to have to put some pressure on myself to get a lot of those files off, because I have a laptop that I could do instead, or I could use. However, I didn't put this on yet. It has got the newer software, and it seems to be even worse. Because it's, I don't know how to explain it. The new software on my laptop is the one for the new machine. The update that I'm working on my desktop is not for the new machine. The other one for the new machine, even on my laptop, just bites. Anybody's had the same issues or had trouble with it, leave me a comment. Tell me what you did. Maybe I can bypass sitting on the phone with Silhouette. If I could possibly do that, that would be awesome. I just don't have the time. Guys, I'm just so incredibly busy. This one, like I said, I had to cut her in a whole bunch of pieces because I didn't want to eliminate. If I would have made her, I couldn't make her narrow. There wasn't any shortcuts, and there's not another image. Typically, if I'm going to do a 2-foot piece, ideally, I like an image like Zoe and Elmo and Bert and Ernie. There's a bunch of them that are tall and thin, and so making them 2 feet tall, they're not more than 2 feet wide, and that is what I prefer. However, that is not how it happens. You know, that's just, I don't know. And do what I gotta do. And I use a lot of popsicle sticks because there's nothing worse than getting your piece all put together and it gets weak. somebody had mentioned about the mathematical, I guess I'd call it, way of doing this that would make it easier and made absolute total sense. However, I don't always have that option because of the shape of the cutout. And she is one of those that is one of those shapes that isn't that easy. The latest and greatest on anything else, I don't have a clue. Apparently I forgot what I was just going to say. Oh, and I did find out that my mother has dementia. Her and I are, I'm always teasing her about her and I, and my husband included, forgetting things all the time. Well, I'm on meds that I did not know affect your memory, and it happens to be the meds that they doubled my dosage. And after I found out, I thought, that explains a lot of my being an airhead. So I'm going to blame it on the meds, guy. I'm going to blame it on the meds. So if I'm loop-de-doo out there and anyone has an issue with it, blame it on the meds. And if you have an issue with it, get off my channel. How do you like that? I am getting ballsy. Is that what they call it? That isn't what I would have called it in my day, but apparently that's what you call it today, nowadays. That's what my kids say all the time. My poor husband always says I decided to stand up and be heard with him. He liked it better when I never said anything. But as I get older and realize what matters, I have a tendency to point that out. And there we go. Getting there. I am. What I'm doing this seam is I'm gonna seal that bad boy up with some blue. Nope, that's the wrong blue. I don't want to use that. I want to use that dark blue. And let me see about that. I am in need. I just did a stickles order the other day. I'm needing some more, and after I placed my order and got my confirmation back and everything, I also found out I didn't order enough. And usually I don't make those mistakes, but I did this time. Okay, come here, give me your head. Uh-oh, where's your other? There it is. Thought I lost a piece, and I'm just gonna flip out. I hear my mother down there watching TV, so I'm trying to get done here so I can go down and check on her and check her oxygen and everything. Like I was saying earlier, is that I made these little signs. I've got to do that later today. As silly as it may sound, I have a sign that I have to tell her in the morning when she wakes up. Her oxygen is always really low because she doesn't breathe very deep, and so I put a big sign up there that she could see the minute she opened her eyes that told her to breathe in through her nose and out through her mouth. And I asked her, because last night she was crying because she couldn't remember to do that. She gets confused whether it's in, out, or out, in. So I made the sign and she said, oh, but she really felt confident that that was going to help her to remember. So I put them all over the house wherever she sits. I made these little signs telling her. And so this morning she got up and she was all chipper in a good mood and everything, and I said, ooh, I thought, oh, she must have looked at her sign and read it and wasn't feeling tired and out of breath and everything. And so I asked her, because I was sure that that was what happened, and I'm sure that I just stuck my hand in that glitter that I just put on there. Anyway, I asked her and I said, did you read your sign this morning? And she said, oh no, I forgot. So I don't know what made her get chipper, but she was. She started out her day good. She usually starts her day out. Ever since she's had this last virus, she starts her day out being weepy. But I'm hoping she's getting better. And you know, somebody asked me how many glue sticks they go through on a centerpiece, and I always say I don't know. And if you ask me again, I'm going to tell you the same thing. I don't know, but a lot. On these 10, I had to do 10 two-footers. Go through a lot of glue. And there's nothing you can do about it. It is what it is. So, I've got her done. I've got the signs ready to cut out. And then I'm going to call this one done. Need to cut this off a little better. Also, when you make your pegs at the bottom, you need to make sure that they are butt right up against the wood. I've seen people make them and they don't have that, and your pieces will stand better if it's butt right up to the end. If you have a little bit hanging out, this foot touching here helps to reinforce her standing. It's almost like us. If we have our foot down, we balance a whole lot better than we would if we were standing on a stick or a stilt or something. How do you like that for an analogy? Just popped right into my forgetful mind. Anyway, that's it for today, guys. If I have anything else coming up, I will try and film and give you updates. Everyone have a good one. Bye-bye. Hi, I'm back again. I said I was all done, and it was close. I was almost done, but I remembered I wanted to show you what these were gonna look like with the signs. I'm just finishing up a little sign that's gonna go on the birthday table that says, Happy Birthday, Sophia and Celia in the middle there. And these three characters, whatever their names are holding the sign. And I'm just putting the backing on this. I'm using the great big huge sticks for this because I get better support. And there we go. I don't like it when these bend. And I got to tell you a funny story, too. I'm going to tell you a funny story that if any of you would be sensitive to talking about personal, private, or what do I call it? Personal hygiene, whatever you want to call it. You're going to want to shut me off right now because this story is going to be, it was hilarious. Guys, I have to tell you because it was hilarious. Since my mother has been in the hospital and not doing good. Now, keep in mind, she's had four kids and she's nearly 90 years old. She's had three heart attacks, three strokes. She's got dementia, everything else. And being in the hospital has been a little bit difficult. And the lack of oxygen has worsened her dementia. So anyway, she had been worried because she was... She worked nights when I was a kid growing up, so she had to fall asleep during the day to a TV. Just some weird habits. Never slept in a bed. That's why her bedroom set and bedroom has lasted all these years, because I don't think she's ever slept in it. Well, when she came up here, we got a brand new bedroom set, everything for her, but she wants to sleep on the couch. But she told me that she was so afraid of not waking up in the night and having an accident on the bed. So I said, well, we can prevent that. We'll put a mat down, get a rubber mat, like a sheet mat that you would use a crib. So she felt better about that. And all of a sudden I had this brainstorm and I thought, you know what, at night, why don't you wear a Depends? And that way you're not gonna be nervous, because I know she's terrified that she is going to have an accident. So she said, that sounds like a good idea. And so I sent my husband out to get them. I wasn't going to buy them. But he went out and got them. And she was really, really not fighting on doing that at all. But my husband calls me downstairs the other day. And he calls me down to the laundry room. And I know you know where this is headed. But he calls me down to the laundry room, and I go down there, and he shows me there's this stuff that looks like jelly ball. I don't know what it is. It's the same stuff you see in diapers. It was all over the place. And he said, he looked at me, and he goes, Depends are not made to be washed in the washing machine and thrown in the dryer. Apparently, when I had grabbed my mother's clothes. We've been doing her laundry, and because she's been sick and stuff, I want to make sure that all of her stuff is washed daily and anything that she has, including her bedding and pillowcases and stuff. I don't wash those every day, but I spray them down with Lysol every day. Just, I want to keep germ-free as possible. Here's one of my signs, Sophia Street. I left the 123. This is the sign that normally says Sesame Street, and I'm pop-dotting them and putting them on the characters. I am not going to do all of them. What I'm going to do is Sophia and Cecilia, but what I'm going to do is put Sophia on one side and Cecilia on the other side, so that if the girls had a preference for, I don't know how old the little girls are, but if they had a preference and one liked Big Bird and wanted that to be her street, this way they both share every single character. That's my thoughts on that. I hope that that didn't seem way out there, but that was what I came up with. But anyway, my husband spent an hour and a half with the vacuum cleaner, with the dryer, and it was in the washer. It was everywhere. And so I told my mom to make sure, and I don't know if it was her or me, if I just grabbed the pile and threw it on the floor, not paying any attention. But there were also black socks in there. Well, her socks now need to be shaved. They're so covered with little, and I said, well, you know, she said, look at my socks. I said, we'll buy new socks, just let it go. But don't wash Depends. They are not machine washable. Just an FYI. Okay, there we go. We have Sophia and we have Cecilia. And I'll put them up another, and let me look at the number that just called me and see if it was anybody of importance. And it wasn't. It wasn't. So we're all good. So I'm going to do another one. Cecilia and Sophia Street. I think those little signs just make it complete. I like them with the signs. However, I don't want to put the sign out here because this is a 2-foot centerpiece, and the box that my husband's going to ship it in, I guarantee, is going to be a 26 by 22. And if I put the sign out here like him holding it up, it's not going to fit in the box, and my husband will come down and wreak havoc on me. He gets so upset when he has to use a 26 by 26 box on these because it's not necessary. It's because I forget and put something where it shouldn't go because I know darn well it's going to take up space. So this one is going to go on his little tummy. Sophia. I think they just add. You guys are going to have to let me know, but I think they just add. They add something. I don't know what, but they do. And what else? Why are these all Cecilia? Come on. Where's the Sophia? Here's a Sophia. I was just down with my mom. I took a break here and check and make sure everything was okay. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to make her independent, because when the nurse came in, they do an assessment to make sure that the where she's living, she's in safe surroundings. They've been really sticklers on coming here and taking her stats and things like that. And even when she got out of the hospital, there had to be an assessment before they would let her come home. I guess they make the decision whether they believe she needs to be in a nursing home. And she's not at that point. She does have dementia, but she knows what's going on. However, she's forgotten how to do things. I don't know if she's forgotten or it's that she's so out of her element. She's lived it on her own her entire life, and now all of a sudden she's living with me, and I got her an iPhone and iPad and new computer and everything, and she's overwhelmed. So we've been doing one thing at a time. Like I said earlier, I was putting up the sign to remind her to do her breathing. Well, right now I went down and I said, Mom, you know what you're going to do today? And she's like, okay, what? And I know she gets thinking, oh my God, what's that girl going to make me do now? I said, you are going to make your own lunch. And she's like, okay. And I said, and I have to explain to her the reason that I'm having her do that is because I do not want the home health people to come in and say that she is not capable of taking care of herself should it be that we were gone. You know, if my husband and I went somewhere or whatever, it realistically, she's not going to go everywhere we go. That's not realistic. So anyway, I said, we got to make sure you know how to do these things because we've been doing them for her since she got here. And so, her response to me was, okay, I know. She said, all I have to do is go in the refrigerator, whatever in the refrigerator. So if it was just eating cheese sticks, that's what she was going to be eating. And she did end up making herself a sandwich, but she's so cute. She's like, okay. Then I'm also teaching her how to take her saturation, her oxygen, and I have the breathing signs everywhere, and I want her to monitor that. And I said, if you feel lightheaded, if you feel any of the symptoms of anything, first thing I want you to do is check your oxygen level. And if it's low, we're trying to wean her off. I have weaned her off. She's not on, only at night she's on oxygen, but during the day there's no need. All she does is have to do is breathe deep through her nose. So I'm making her monitor, and so she feels lightheaded, making her use the probe herself and read it until I told her where it has to be at. But what I have to do today is write up a list and plastic coat it of, she wants duties. She wants things that she can do to keep her active. But if I tell her what she can do, she's not gonna remember. So I gotta make up a list today. One of them is, well, there are a whole lot of them, but I want her to be where she's not lost if we're gone for an hour. And so far she understands that, but she's pretty funny because she's, I think sometimes she looks at me like, I'm at your mercy, whatever you say. And it's a really strange thing, and if anybody's done this, by taking care of a grandparent or a parent, is they bring you into this world and they take care of you as an infant and as a child, and they guide you as a teenager. And when you become a parent, you know, when you go to them, especially girls with their mothers, me in particular, when I had my first baby, I was living in Venezuela, but I came home to have my baby, and I was staying at my mom's, and I remember feeling this overwhelming sense of, I don't know what to do when she cries and whatever. But anyway, you go through these things and you go, your mother. Then all of a sudden in life, you're taking care of a parent and you're taking care of them as though they were a child. And they look at you, and my mother looks at me, and it that does make me feel bad, is because she's got a look of total dependency on me. And that's huge. That's huge for them to think and feel that way. To me it is anyway, because it's almost scary thinking that she's thinking, oh my God, what would I do if she wasn't here? So if anybody goes through that or is going through it, you know, you gotta be there to understand what that is. It's unbelievable. But I would not do it any other way. My husband and I made the joint decision to take care of her, and that is what we will do. And on that note, I'm trying to finish these up, guys. And I was trying to finish them up last night. I stayed up until 1 o'clock in the morning to get these done, because it's been really hard for me to work during the day. And apparently I'm not doing very good. But all good. It's all good. So, anyway, I think that on that note, I'm going to, I don't want to cover up that lip, and I don't know where I want that. I think I'm going to put it right there. I made that decision a little bit late in the game. Should put it popped in there. There we go. These are so cute. Listen to me. These are so cute. Okay, that's it. I'm going to let you guys go and give you a break from my excessive babbling. And the next thing I'm going to be working on that I will film, is probably Shimmer and Shine and some scrapbooking, guys. I promise I'm going to get some scrapbooking as soon as I'm caught up. Anyway, have a great week. It's Wednesday already. The remainder of your week. Bye-bye.